Hi guys, nice to meet you here. My name is Mike and I'm doing engineering for Fluent Labs. And today I am going to tell you about the Fluent Compute Engine. So I will pronounce this like FCE. And this engine is intended to run multimodal WebAssembly applications with help of interface types. In particular, the agenda of my talk is follows. So first of all, I will just say a couple of words about the Fluent, just two slides. Then I also talk a little bit about WebAssembly and especially about interface types proposal. I believe that many of you know a lot about WebAssembly, but I will just highlight several important points that needed for other part of this talk. And then I will talk a lot about the Fluent SDK and the architecture of FCE. And finally, I will talk why, in my opinion and opinion of our team, Rust is one of the most suitable languages for any projects using WebAssembly. And also, I will try to compare some features that we found in Rust most suitable for WASM with C++. Also, I will try to grab all questions from Q&A section at the end of each topic. So please write them. So let's move on and start with the Fluent architecture. So Fluent is decentralized functions service that intended to run WebAssembly modules with several important features. So the first one is zero DevOps. Here zero DevOps means that all DevOps is done by Fluent network and Fluent nodes. The next one is the easiest integration with other modules. I will talk a lot about it next slides. And the last one is a special language called Aquamarine that provides a way to run complex multi-agent request scenarios across the Fluent network. And we hope that in the future, Fluent will allow developers to be get paid automatically for distinct modules or maybe entire applications by the royalty model. Here, royalty model means that developers will be get paid by the fact that their modules or applications are used by anyone in the Fluent network. On this slide, you can see the overview of the Fluent network. Here we have several special terms. The first one is a module. Yes, module is just a piece of code that compiled to WebAssembly with special API. I will talk a lot about this API in next slides. And several modules can be compiled to entity code service. So here service can be considered like an application or just a program. And in its turn, several services can form so-called backend. So backend is a group of services that has functions. So functions is the last term on the slide. And functions written on Aquamarine, a special language that based on pcalculus. And function can communicate with all services that form this backend. And moreover, each service can be located on separated peer inside Fluent's network. So just a distributed system. So in here, all functions of this backend form API of this backend, and users can communicate with this API by special SDK. So this SDK won't be presented on the slides, but if you want more, we'll share the link on our Twitter and on the last slides, and here will be all updates. So let's move on to the next section about WebAssembly and interface types. As I already said, I just highlight several points, but I really love this slide. This slide taken from Ben Smith talks last year's PPCon. You can find it by this link. And here you can see a directed graph and moving from left to right, you can construct your own definition what is WebAssembly. So I ended with this one. And here is the most important point that WebAssembly has only four or five, depending on the version, primitive types. So there are just integers and floating point types. Yes, there are no any strings, arrays, enums, structures, and so on. So just only such types. And another gem from the WebAssembly world is WASI. So WASI stands for WebAssembly System Interface, and it's just a standard for imports. Yes, for imports from WASM module. They look like this one. there are just like a POSIX like imports. There are about 50 of them. You can find it by this link, all of them. And what is the most marvelous thing is such imports. So here you can see two whole words written on Rust and C++. And if you compile it with WASI SDK, so I mean WASI SDK for C++ and with WASI 32 WASM target for Rust, you can obtain such five imports in your WASM binary. So the good thing here is that just so WASM is a place where two words, Rust and C++, can communicate this and can compile to form that similar to each other. And but not so easy, of course. Not so easy because we have only primitive types in WebAssembly. On the slide, you can see a complex scheme, and in the middle, yes, this one, this box, represents WebAssembly module. Yes, this module is just a raw module with primitive types. So I mean that each import and export of this module can operate only by primitive types. So in here, you can see other module, so-called adapter, adapted module, yes. And the purpose of this module is just to wrap this one. And here, by wrapping, I mean that for each import and each export inside this WASM raw module, there could be corresponding adapted import and adapted export. So, and the purposes of such import adapters, so just to lowering and lifting types between interface types, so between complex types to raw types, yes? So interface types here is a string, arrays, records, and so on. The second takeaway from this slide is just WASM in binary format divided into sections. So here there are two sections, two types of sections. So the last one is this so-called custom section. So this custom section has user-defined format. So and the user can save anywhere in the section. So it just it could be just raw bytes. So anything that the user scripts, user tools can parse. And usually interface types should be located in this custom section. There is no any special section inside binary. So, and it's important for other part to this talk to know that in WASM binaries that support interface types, there should be special custom sections with some information that supports such interface types. This information includes, for example, implementation of such adapters, mapping between adapters and corresponding import and exports, so and so on. So we can find a proposal by this link. And the current state of this proposal, IT here is not information technology, it just stands for interface types. So the current state is level one. So there are actually fifth levels from 0 to 4, yes, and interface types on the first one, on the feature proposal state, is just the early stage, yes. And if you look at the repository, this one, so you can see that there were no updates for a long time, yes. So, and there were not any video calls and so on. But about 3 weeks ago, there was a huge pull request. You can find it by this link. So on this request rewrites a lot interface types. So just it's a very, very huge pull request. But in my talk, I concentrate only on master state of interface types because this one isn't merged now. So on just a pull request and there are some discussions in it. So I will concentrate on the master state of interface types. And as far as I know, interface types aren't used for any server-side application, and maybe only one tool that support interface types, so support generation of interface types, is WASM Bindgen. I will show you later, but on the current stage, interface types only partially applicable, yes, applicable, sorry, and can be used out of the box. So let's move on. And here you can see two of the most important WebAssembly runtimes, WASMer and WASMtime, both written on C++. To be honest, there is another very important runtime called WAVM. It's written on C++, and it's the so-called reference implementation. So all docs, some docs in WebAssembly refers to such WebAssembly runtime. But WAVM isn't support interface types at all. So in WASMer, you can find a separate virtual machine agnostic rate, so by this link. But to use this one, you need a lot of job because it's intended for outdated version of WASMer. And in WASMtime, support of interface type was dropped on March this year. But guys has a lot of plans, especially now with Fastly umbrella, and you can find discussion here by this in this issue. Let's move to the question. So we have one question. So text representation here. By text representation here, I mean that. WebAssembly has two formats. First one is a binary format, yes, with a divided section. And the next one is a text format or WAT format. So I can share a link with more information later. So let's move on and discuss the Fluence Rust SDK. So when we start to think about our SDK, we ended with such requirements. So we want that our SDK be the most convenient for users, yes? And maybe it seems that it should be similar to something familiar. And the only familiar thing here, and maybe it was one of the most important projects from Rust ecosystem for WebAssembly, is the WASM engine. The last one is the easiest way to port existing projects to WebAssembly and to Fluence network. So actually, we also tried to port WASM engine for server side, but we ended that we need to rewrite about 90% of WASM engine because 90% devoted to communication with JavaScript. So and it use was in our goal. So despite all the limitations, because as I said, interface times aren't supported by any WebAssembly runtime out of the box. But with interface types, you can write in vanilla Rust. So by vanilla Rust, I mean that, for example, in this whole world, the only thing that you need to write is just a procedure macros called FC, yes? So, and this one means that this function called greeting, you will be exported functions from compiled WebAssembly binary. And so here you can see that we can use complex Rust types, yes? So not just integer floating point, but string, arrays, and other types I will show you later. So the complete example you can find by this link. And maybe the most important feature of Fluence Compute Engine is support of shared nosync linking scheme between modules. Actually, there are two main linking schemes in WebAssembly world. The first one is shared nosync. In this linking scheme, modules combined and shares only import and export. So just they link it together by corresponding import and export. So here you can see an example. So modules could see and could obtain from other modules only import and export. So it's just a module encapsulate all state inside. Second one is shared everything. So by this linking scheme, you can share everything from a WebAssembly module, for example, memory, table, and so on. So at now, we support only shared nothing because I think that it's maybe one of the most useful linking scheme. And here you can see how it looks like from the source code. Here you can see three WASM binaries. First one is size storage, curl, and local storage. And all of this example, so just an example, it provides a way to download with curl is a utility, common one utility. Download links, yes, by URL, and save it somewhere in file system. So again, just an example to provide a way how it looks like from a developer point of view. So this function will be exported, and here you can see that this site storage linked with these two WebAssembly modules, yes, with curl and local storage. And to link and to provide information about function signature, here you can see that in Rust we have foreign mode, foreign block. Yes, and the only way, so the only thing that you need to do to provide a way how complex type should be used inside this block is just to use, again, the procedure macros. So, and here you can see that, so the only thing that we need to do, and then we can use such functions inside our code. Passing structures is also allowed, and the only thing that also you need to do is just to write the procedure macro on top of the structure. And so inside interface types, inside master version, this all structures named records, so just a test record. And after that, after applying such procedure macro, you can use it inside inside arguments and inside and as a return output type of functions with such procedure macro. So as I said, interface types. So to generate binary with interface types, we need such binary to have a custom section, yes, with interface types. But also here we have other problem. The other problem is that in Rust, the current state procedure macros aren't stateful, and moreover, their order of applying isn't defined. So, and to solve such problem, we are using a two-stage scheme of compilation, like in Wasm engine. So on the first stage, we expanding macro, and in such state, we generate extra information that then will be used on the second stage, where we use this information to generate interface types. So it use like this. On the first stage, so this one, this example, expand to such form. And here we have such global that contains JSON string that has all information needed to generate interface types. So in this global is placed inside custom section. So the binary could have a lot custom sections. And on last step, we remove such sections from the WASM binary, from the WASM intermediate binary, and put it to the resulted WASM binary. So all of this is done by our utility FC, so we can just write FC build, and here you can pass all flags like you can pass in cargo, yes, like for example release and so on. On the current stage, we are supported the following types. So all integers, all floating points, string, vectors, and structures that contains all of such types. For example, recursive structures is also possible, and recursive arrays also possible, like something like this one. Of course, we have several limitations because we started FC about 5 months ago, and we have maybe two main things to do inside our Rust SDK. First one is the support enums and box types like RC, box, and so on. The next one is support passing by reference because now everything is passed by value. So let's move to the questions. So for C++, what is procedure macro? So actually, I think that maybe I can't answer to this in short form. Maybe I will pass also a link. But a procedure macro is a special macro that can can receive token stream on the token that it's applying to. Yes, for example, it can receive token stream of function or structures or foreign mode or something like that. So, and based on such token stream, you can just generate a new token stream. And with help of this, in our RSSDK, so such sections is generated. So, but it's just a short and very non-complete answer. So I will provide a link after my slide ends. So let's move on and see how Fluent Compute Engine looks inside. So actually, it has three layers. On the first layer, we have such support, so utility crates that aims to support internal Fluent features, so services that was on the third or fourth slide, and Aquamarine. Yes? So our special language is also compiled to WebAssembly, and we execute it inside our FC. On the next level, we have function as a service, so it's aims just to, for example, create some directories. It also has a method that receive JSON, and you can, for example, so Flask can extract interface types from here. So interface types all information about function, and can deserialize JSON in such a way that it could be. It could be then pass to the next level to FC. We believe that such architecture can suit in other scenarios, for example, in like entity company systems, like for example, in plugin system in games and something like that. So we can find OFC code by this link. And maybe the most important for third-party developers where is the lowest one, FC. So it has such interface. So of course it can load and unload modules. So modules can be loaded with name and with special configuration file that has a lot of configs. So I will show you later. Also you can see WASI state of a module. Yes, here by WASI state I mean that you can obtain all environment variables that are used inside this module. And moreover, you can obtain all inodes that are open inside file system. So you can, for example, see what files are used by this module now. So next one here is the interface. So interface is the so it's just a iterator. Yes, iterator of all signatures, all exported functions inside of all modules that currently loaded inside FC. So in the last one, of course, you can call modules by name, function, module name, function name, and with arguments. Here, I value, so it means like interface value, so just enum that has branches of all complex types that were supported. So it's all integer, floating point types, strings, vectors, records, and so on. So here you can see possible configuration of a service. As you remember, service is divided into modules, and these modules could, should be loaded in the order that they defined in this configuration file. And inside, for each module, can adjust. For example, a logger, so a percent of logger. And also there is option that missed here is the maximum memory size that this module can use inside FC. And also you can adjust WASI state, especially pre-opened files. So pre-opened files here is only files that could be accessible for such module, yes? So this module can open and can operate on these files that listed here, and for such files you can use aliases, yes, with such map dirs, and last one is the mounted binaries. So mounted binaries is the binaries that can be used outside the WebAssembly module. So in Fluence, we realized that not every software can be ported to WebAssembly and on Fluence. For example, complex databases like MySQL, like MariaDB, and so on can be ported to WebAssembly now. Because, for example, WASI isn't supported sockets and asynchronous API, and WebAssembly is single-threaded now in MVP. So we have a backdoor here, and such thing allows you to use curl function inside the module. Yes, that can receive a string, and it returns a string. Yes, and this string is passed directly to such CLI, and the result of it returned by this function. So we can find the complete example also here by this link. So, and let's move into the details and see how multimodal calls work inside of C. So here, as I already said, for each import inside and each export inside WASM instance, here it's called WASM instance because we are based on WASMer. And for each import and each export, there is corresponding adapter import and adapter export. And inside each such adapter, there is a separated interpreter. Yes, this is a real interpreter that has its own stack, and it operates on interface types instructions. So let's see how call of curl is work. Here you can see so that such adapters will be linked together. And on the first stage, here from this WASM module, we call import adapter for curl, the curl method. And here you can see instructions that will be generated by our FCE. So this is only part of such instructions that contains import adapter for method curl. And here you can see four instructions. The first two just place to stack two values. The first one is a pointer to a string, and the second one is a size of string, yes? Because third one, lift memory, use pointer and size just to lift memory. So lift memory here means that this instruction get memory from this module to host. Yes, host here is a Rust, the code that we are, for example, that we're writing on Rust inside VFC. Yes, I will call it like host. So in a virtual machine world, so we have guest and host, and here host is this one, and guest is WASM modules. So in here, by such instruction, we can grab memory to UTF-based string. And then we call export adapter in curl instance. So here you can see instructions of this adapter. In the prologue, yes, we need to worry in memory back to this WASMer instance, yes, to this WASM instance, to curl. So, and we do it in such a way. So first of all, we obtain size of string. So this instruction placed string on the stack, and it gets string and pushes back the size of string in bytes. And then we use special function allocate that each module should export, so each module should export allocate and deallocate. And here we call allocate inside this one. So we see that it shared nothing linking scheme. So we call allocate, and then we use pointer that returned by this allocate function. Again, the string with in worried memory. Yes, here we worry in memory to such module, and only then call real function inside this WASM instance. But then we have a problem. So here we have problem that it's problem inside the current state of interface types. So in here we need the same operation as here. Yes, we need to orient string back to this side storage module. But to do this, we need two copies of the string. So first one will be consumed by string size, and second one by string word in memory. But on the current master stage, there is no any instruction for duplicating and swapping values on stack. So there are there just comes in this pull request, but there are no any separated instructions. It's like dup and swap that we added in our fork of interface type. So there is a new let that comes from linking proposal separate one. So it provides a way how value can be duplicated inside stack. So in here, with help of this instruction, we can realize the same logic as here. So, and then we orient memory back to the initial site storage WASM instance. So let's move on. And here is the other feature of Fluent Compute Engine. So it's host functions. So actually, host function is a function that exported from host to guest, yes, to WASM module. So of course, it's main features of all WebAssembly runtimes, like WASM mirror, like WAVM, WASM time, and so on. But in our case, we're also using interface types here. So and here you can see import descriptor that should be used to link host function to corresponding module, yes? And here you can see, so this is closure, this is the way how we can define a closure inside Rust. And here you can see that this closure takes a mutable context. So with this context, we can modify memory, we can obtain table, and so on. So just a WASMir API, just WASMir context from WASMir API. So next argument is a array of I values. So I value is a enum with complex types. Yes, and this function return option. So it's like a std option of I value. So in here we need to do it static. So maybe I can describe it later because I run out of time, running out of time. So, and other two fields here is argument types and output types. Here we need such such fields to for proper linking, yes, because here we have just a vector, so it's runtime values, but here we need compile time values to link our exported function from host to corresponding WebAssembly module. And the last one is the error handler. So the last way how errors from lifting. So because here we also lift, so we, under the hood, we lift memory, we lift values. And in such purpose, there could be errors. Yes, they are denoted by such enum. And you can define your own error handler. And if it will be none, so the default here is just panic. So panic is just exit. To test all of this, we have repo with such functions. So it can load, unload, calling, create new. So in here you can see fs that print file system state. So all open inodes inside each, so inside WebAssembly module that that identified by the such name. Here you can see an example of dealing with IPFS. So here is also two modules, IPFS pure and IPFS effector. And here are two main functions inside all of them, put and get. And here you can see that put takes file content and the get and return string. So the string is a hash of file content that will be uploaded inside IPFS network. And by second one, by get, you can download back your file by hash. So on here you can see an example. So IPFS code, just code with this such JSON with three numbers, 1, 2, and 3. And here you can see results, the hash of such array. And here also we can get it back. Here you can see result also our numbers 1, 2, and 3. Also, we maybe you can realize that there are a lot of overhead here to instantiate module, to compile them, or something like that. So we ported Redis, so that you know written on C. We ported it on WebAssembly, and this Redis, so in optimized version with ripped debug section, takes about half megabytes on the file system. So, and loading this database takes about half a second. Yes. So loading here means that this one will be compiled with crane lift and instantiate. Yes. So all import and export will be instantiated, and all interpreters will be also created. And also we have partially lazy linking scheme, and corresponding calling will be much faster than previous one. So this is the first one. So here you can see the first one takes about 3 milliseconds, and then it's about, so this one is a microsecond, yes, it's a mu. So it's about 64 microseconds. So just, I think it's just fast. Especially that we aren't especially optimized LFC, so just write in with best practices, but we don't use any features like, for example, likely, unlikely, like some other tools from HFT and so on. So, of course, we have some plans. So, first of all, we want to implement shared everything linking scheme. Also, we want to support full lazy linking. Yes, now we have only partially one. As I said, we want to support more arguments inside Rust SDK, like boxer types, like enum structures, and so on. Also, we want to make FC virtual machine agnostic and support wasm time, and also support multi-values. So let's move to the next section. I will check Q&A. So there are no any questions. So let's move on to why we think that Rust is one of the most useful languages for WebAssembly. So you can see here several points, but actually I joined inside WebAssembly world, as it could be said, about 2.5 years ago. And about 2 years ago, I wanted to compile some big thing like MySQL, like Redis, like SQLite that written in C to WebAssembly. So, and actually we had other project inside Fluent that is a verifiable computing the network. So it's similar to this one, but the main purpose that you was deterministic execution. And we want to compile code without any imports, because imports is a way of deterministic behavior inside WebAssembly. I think it's obvious. And so this target, WASM32 unknown, is intended for such purposes. But in C and C++, in 2 years ago, before WASI, yes, so WASI appears about 1.5 year ago, so in March 2019. So the compiling C and C++ to WASM was very tricky. So you can you should download special libc that wasn't official, yes, and just developed by some guy, and so there should be a lot of problems with such target. So I'll show you on the next slide one of them. But in Rust, such option will be could be used from the very beginning. So we can just Rust up add target, and you can just type this target, and always done. Yes, so you can use by only so on, the only thing you need to do is just to type only one CLI command, and you can compile code inside WebAssembly. So it was very, very marvelous on that time. But now, of course, we have WASI, so and WASI could be used inside Rust, inside C++ in easy way. But in Rust, it also could be done in only one easy CLI command. Also, there is the third one, WASI32EM scripting. So here isn't listed. The next one is, of course, procedural macros. Yes, I show the power of procedural macros. And I think you realize that this such behavior, these interface types, will be very, very tricky to implement in SDK for C++ without procedural macros. So I mean that you need special code analyzer or maybe special annotation tool or something like that to provide a way how expert with complex type could be compiled to raw types. So, and of course, Rust, as James said, has good ecosystem and modern amenities. So here you can see example of WASM32 unknown target. So the main power of such target is that it provides a way how several primitives could be compiled without imports. For example, here you can see a piece of code that I grabbed from implementation of Mutex for WASM target. And if you try that time, compile Mutex in C++, you can see a lot of imported functions. Walk, unwalk, and so on will be imported. Yes, so, but in Rust, guys thought that, oh, WebAssembly is single-threaded, so we can just implement Mutex with just one simple value, yes, and that's all. So now you work. The same story with allocator. So Rust has dlmalloc, that ported dlmalloc to Rust, and it also compiled to WASM targets. So, and there shouldn't be any imports that allow allocation memory, like in C++. Also, as I said, Rust support, of course, WASM32. WASI target. And here I think that for C++ and for Rust, there are the same features, yes? All is a, maybe you remember a slide that I provide an example how simple whole world could be compiled to WASI target. So on here, I think I see a way how two languages, how modules from two languages could live together in one environment. For example, in IFC, you can use Redis, SQLite written in C. You already ported them, and you can Rust. You can write Tiny wrapper with Rust, and such three modules could communicate with each other. So I think that WASM is a world where two languages are met. Yes. But of course, there are two main features that we are missing in Rust ecosystem. The first one is already said stateful procedure macros, and the deterministic order of the of applying. You can find this issue that the guys discussed how they could be implemented in Rust. And the second one is a very minor one, maybe, but it's hard us because. Currently in Rust, if you have workspace inside inside your project, you can't easily use, for example, cargo check or cargo build from the root of your directory. Yes, you it's a tricky way only how to compile all targets, so all crates inside your workspace to different targets. Yes, for example, if one should be compiled to WebAssembly and another to native target, and for example, WebAssembly uses like some imports that shouldn't be resolved in native, so there will be a problem. So, thank you all for the attention. today I was presented FC, so and Rust SDK. You can find them by this link. If you have any questions, I would be glad to answer them by, for example, Telegram. So here you can find my link, or by email, or for example with issues. So also we are preparing for soft launch that will be on at the beginning of November, and you can find all information in our Twitter and by email newsletter in our official site. So thank you again. I will check Q&A. So we have one question. So big questions we have then. Yes, it's like a plugin system. So for example, you can construct your own application with separated modules. And here we see a power of Fluence. For example, for developers, developer can make, for example, a Tiny module, but it would be a very useful one. And anyone can integrate it in their own services. And these developers will be get paid by the royalty model, by the fact that their module, it could be very, very simple, but very useful, as I said. So by that, the module used by anyone in the Fluence network. So the answer is yes.